Hey, what's up, you guys? Welcome back to my channel. My name is Mary L, and I am Imperfectly Mary L. If this is your first time stopping by, thank you so much. If you are a returning subscriber, let me just take this moment to say the feedback that I got from my last video was so heartfelt. Thank you so much to everyone who messaged me, texted me. I didn't mean to stir up emotion in a lot of you guys. A lot of you basically was like, oh my God, at this point when you said that, I lost it. Or I thank you so much for being empathetic. And even though you can't relate, but you were able to just, you know, take a moment to just walk this with me and understand how I must have felt in that moment. So thank you so much, you guys. I wanted to take this moment though to discuss the purpose of me sharing this. A lot of you guys were like, well, why now? Why did you decide to share now? Because as I mentioned before, this wasn't something that I went around broadcasting. I kept it very secretive. It was embarrassing. It was, you know, I was under the stigmatism of being undocumented, so I didn't go around. Some of my closest friends didn't even know. And so I wanted to take a moment to share now what my purpose in sharing this, you know, basically being. My purpose was to basically put a face to what it is that is illegal immigration. I wanted to show you that I am your next door neighbor. I'm your coworker. I am your bartender. I am your cook. I am your waitress. I am your nanny. I am your overnight nurse. I am the person that takes care of your elderly grandmother, mother, father. I am your housekeeper. Someone who you love. I'm pretty sure every single one of you, if not most of you, if not every single one of you, have dealt with someone who you love dearly. You know, little Miss Maria, who cleans your house very well. Little Miss, you know, Marie, who is, you know, so kind with your children. She cooks and she cleans and she takes care of your household. You probably don't know that she doesn't have papers, but 9 times out of 10, she does not have papers. Jose, who takes care of your grass, the person that helped you pack up and move your entire house. Your favorite bartender, your favorite waiter, waitress. Again, the line cook at your favorite restaurant. The person that you, if you walk into the restaurant, this person's not there, you're not staying. That person, 9 times out of 10, is undocumented. Because the reason why I emphasize the restaurant is because restaurants are one of the more forgiving places to work if you're undocumented. And so I guarantee you, you've rubbed shoulders with someone who's undocumented and didn't even know it. Their English is perfect. They've been here forever. They look a certain way. I've been in the club. I've bagged the best of them. They didn't know I was undocumented. I've traveled. I've done. There's no umbrella that you can really put an undocumented person under. So I want this concept that all undocumented people are gangbangers and criminals, and you know, they look a certain way. That's not true. They don't speak all the same. They don't look all the same. You know, so that's my motive in doing this. I wanted to just kind of humanize what it is to be undocumented. I wanted to show you that your neighbor, someone who is near and dear to your heart, may very well be battling this, but it's not something that's glamorized. It's not something that people like to talk about because of the stigma, because it's frowned upon. So I just wanted to show you that some of the people that you may very well be close to may be walking this walk and you just don't know about it. So while a lot of people feel how they feel about crossing illegally or illegal immigration, you have to think deeper. You have to have a more broad perspective of it, because not all of us have the same story. While my story may be this, another person's story may be that, we don't all come in the same. I remember back in the 90s, the biggest thing was, oh, you got on a boat. You came here on a boat. I didn't come here on a boat. I flew with the flight attendants. If I'm not mistaken, I flew first class. I came into America where I had all the snacks. I was very well. I didn't come here on a boat. Nor did I cross the Rio Grande. I was not walking for miles and miles in the it's not all one. It's not all one. And so That's my purpose in doing this. I didn't want to, again, stir up emotion for you guys. I know a lot of you are like, wow, I've known you. I had an ex-coworker who I worked with back in Atlanta years ago. Was like, I know you kind of fell off the face of the earth. I didn't know, like, what was what. And I'm like, you would have never known. That's not something I was, especially not at work. I wasn't going to share this at work. And so he was just like, wow, like, that's amazing. And like I said, the feedback that I'm getting so far is very positive. And I appreciate you guys for having an open mind and listening to me. And continue to share my story, because like I said, somebody that you know is dealing with this, and maybe at some point we can have more dialogue, which will lead to more people discussing their situation, which would open the conversation floor to what needs to be changed in the immigration system, because we absolutely have a broken immigration system in the US. And so hopefully this leads to that. I don't know who will ever see my videos, if anyone. I think I'm a little under 100 subs right now. That may be what it is, or I may blow up, who knows. The sky's the limit. I'm a very optimistic person. I believe anything is possible, but for the moment, if this helps anyone, at least educate you on what it is to be illegal, that's my purpose. And so what I wanted to do was have a Q&A. One of my good friends suggested that I had a Q&A and basically talk about, you know, have you guys ask me questions, and what, you know, some of the questions that you guys may have for me. Why didn't I share this? What, you know, led to this? And just different questions that you guys may have based on my last video. And so what I'll do is share that on my social media and come back and maybe make a separate video on some of the questions that you have. But please, if you have any questions, drop that in the comments and ask them. Feel free to ask them. I want to know what you guys think. I want to know what questions you have. I want to let's talk. I like the feedback. And so let's do that. And then on the next video, hopefully I'll have those questions plus these questions, and I'll, you know, pretty much answer them as best as I can. And so, as always, thank you for watching. I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.